Namaste, this is Mekhala here from poojas.in. I'm here today to answer a few of your queries based on the previous video that I had posted about how to connect to Lord Shiva during the Kartik Mass. So I had a few viewers, some clients also, asking me, ma'am, why do we need to wear a bindi? Why do we need to wear kumkum? What is the significance of wearing vibhuti? Or wearing a rudraksh, you know, how is it really going to help? So I want to tell you scientifically what exactly happens when you wear all these things. So basically they are all good conductors of divine energy, which is why, you know, our rishis or ancestors always have worn it. And the other gurus who have meditated have also had visions of rishis wearing these. So that way I want to say that I want to assure you that yes, definitely they are very good conductors of energy. And you know, it's like an invitation to the divine forms. You know, you're calling them and telling, yeah, I'm ready to receive your grace. Please come and bless me. So that is one very good reason why you should consider wearing these signs. You know, whether it's a kumkum or a vibhuti, or wearing a rudraksha bead in your neck, or wear earrings or bracelet. See, I always have this with my bangle. So I never go out without a rudraksha. So why is it like that? Because, you know, even in, there have been instances in the Guru Charitra, if you have read about the Dattatreya Guru Charitra, you will see that, you know, these are things which have protected the souls even after their life. So there are instances where you know, people had to leave their body, the devoted devotees, and when the Yamadutas come to take the soul, you know, because the death has happened to the body, the Shivadutas have also appeared at the same time and have not allowed Yamadutas to take back the soul to Yamaloka. Instead, they have, with a lot of reverence and respect, taken the souls to the Shivaloka. See, that there's a difference. In Yamaloka, there is always, you know, they say there is both the things, suffering and good karma, bad karma. In Shivaloka, it's only Shiva Sanidhya. So, why I'm insisting on these things is because Sanatana Dharma is such a, it has such a broad perspective. It has such a broad vision. It has so much scope for you in this life and even afterlife. So, don't just think it's about today. It's not about just tomorrow or day after and, you know, 6 years down the line. It's not like those things, you know, the financial planning that we think we do. It's much beyond that. So it's all planning based on previous life, this life, and any, you know, life, if at all, in future, which we all try to avoid, you know, the through sadhana. So that is exactly why I told you to do all that. And what to, you know, just to briefly tell you, it's not like from day one I've been following all these things. I have practiced it for some time and I have stopped to see whether there's an impact in my life, and then again I've started. So it's not like you know, it's not a one-sided story at all, because only when you experience you can talk with conviction. Even in the videos of my, you know, the previous videos, whether it's Lakshmi or any other, if at all I have suggested any mantra to anyone, it's only based on my direct experience. What my guru has given me, what Divine Mother has given me, and what my parents have given me. So everything is based on the direct experience. So because experience is what makes you believe. So if it can happen to me, if something good can happen to me, it can happen to you as well. So that's exactly why I've suggested these things. So, you know, wear a kumkum vibhuti, you will instantly feel a change. And vibhuti is also not just some random talcum powder. Basically, it is prepared out of bilwa leaves. They are burnt and then prepared. Some people even burn cow dung and then prepare. So, all auspicious things go into it. So, it will have medicinal values also. So, and when you apply it, usually where do you apply? We apply here, we apply here, we apply here. And maybe in the chest also. So these are all pod chakras, they're all energy centers. So if you feel somewhere your energy center is not activated fully and not fully charged, you are having health problems, if you are stuck in life, you know, when you apply, you start seeing movement, you'll start seeing development, you'll start seeing progress, you'll see growth, you'll see peace, You'll see prosperity. So many things start, good things start happening. It happened to me. So when I had stopped in between, I did have some, fears and, setbacks, I can say. This was when I was in my college. So, but now it's not like that. So now, as we grow, we mature and mentally, and we know that, it's better to be fall in line and, get a good experience. And then you get good experiences, then the conviction grows more and more. You want to tell people, see, I followed it and, it really worked for me. Why don't you do it too? So, that way it's very good. And one thing I want to appreciate is, especially people from the state of Tamil Nadu are very, very, they stick to rituals. They follow all these things very well, and they are seeing phenomenal progress in their life, because they strictly follow whatever is the culture of the state. Likewise, even North Indians are highly commendable, because they also very, very traditionally follow whatever rituals are, they are supposed to follow as per the family traditions. And they also grow, and I have seen many families grow and improve in leaps and bounds, because they have just stuck to their family traditions. So samskaras, we call it, they really help a lot. And another reason, I just want to expand one step further, although you asked me just about the kumkum and vibhuti and rudraksh, I want to expand one step further and say, even if you want to use Shrigan, please go ahead and use it, because it's again a divine, if I can say product in your language. So, because even in Kashi Vishwanath temple, it's a Jyotirling, you may be knowing, there also they smear Lord Shiva with a lot of Shrigant paste. And in fact, even in the Bilwa leaves, the Tridala, we call it, the three leaves of Bilwa, even on that they write Ramanam, and then only they offer it to Lord Shiva. So, divinity is just amazing, and everything is very broad-minded. So, don't restrict yourself to, Shrigant is only Vishnu, Basma is only Shiva. It's not like that. We just have to broaden, and somewhere we have to show our connectivity that we are divine. Okay, so another thing that happens when you do this is, divine beings and beings from other planes, they can be Gandharvas, they could be the Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, Trimurtis, or it could be Siddha Shaktis, Guru Shakti. All of them will start coming to you, because it's like a signboard. You're telling them, I'm ready to receive your grace. I'm ready to receive your guidance. I'm here to get your Chaitanya. So what happens is, automatically they come to you. So if you are you don't have any of these divine elements on yourself, then you may miss the bus. So that's exactly why we recommend. So what are some of the changes that you can see is that, even if you don't have a particular skill or talent, once you have this, when you regularly practice with faith, the Gandharvas especially will come and bless you. So what happens is, you develop a little bit interest, suddenly you develop interest in one particular art, or something in particular, some skill, some talent will slowly unfurl. And it will start as an interest, and then you suddenly see that you are doing something very big time in it. So that's all divine grace only. So through these Gandharvas and higher forms of divinity, you can get the blessings. And why did I tell you to light the lamp, the earthen lamp, is because lamp, again, through ether, the Akasha Tattva, one of the Panchabhutas, like how we have Bhumi, Akasha, Jala, Agni, Vayu, like that, the Akasha Tattva will, through Akasha Tattva, when you light a lamp, the Agni Tattva, you are calling divine forces to come. So to tell that you need that light and you're ready to receive the light. So they will be there to bless you instantly. They'll come and touch your Chaitanya and go, your consciousness. So you'll start feeling peaceful. So just light one lamp and see, even while lighting, you'll feel very good. This happens to me. No matter what, in Kartik Masa, I don't miss on lighting the lamp, the earthen lamp, because I'm keeping it at the doors. Because, you're just inviting divine forces, come, please come and bless me. Be here, protect me. So even while I'm lighting, I feel so good. So you just have to develop a bit of subtlety, and I'm sure you'll also be able to feel the change. So that's why through ether, that is one of the things that you can experience. And even in a temple, not every time in every temple you get to touch the deity or go to the Garbhagriha. But why do you feel peaceful? How? Who is touching you then? Through whom? Through ether only you have this cross exchange of vibrations. So that's why you feel very peaceful. Ah, I went, I prayed, I felt very good. At such a good darshan, you know, I felt very good. So it's always through ether. Even sunlight has to reach us through ether only. So through not only us, all the living beings, this entire planet, all the stratosphere, ionosphere, atmosphere, everything. It just comes through that only, you know. So it's all through ether only. So ether is a very powerful tattva, one of the panchabhuta tattvas, which is there within us, which is there outside of us also. So the connectivity is established faster. Okay, so that is why even lighting an agarbatti is again through ether. You are creating that atmosphere. We don't light agarbatti and keep it near our nostrils. We usually, what do? We light an agarbatti and we show it to God like this, no? So why do we do that? It's because through ether you are calling them to come and connect you. So we don't know these backgrounds and we just quickly we just do that and then just keep it aside. And sometimes what we do, if the fragrance is very strong, we light only one, and you know, we are supposed to light two. So like that, we have our own adjustments. So but we should not be doing any of those things. Just follow the rituals. You have to light two, light two. And why are you doing this? Next time you remember, I am doing this to attract divine grace, to attract their attention, to call them, invite them. So that is what you are doing. And even Mangalarti we do, no? The Aarti, what we perform. It's all because through Agni Tattva you want the grace. So first we show it to divinity and then we take it and then we ourselves take it like this. So why do we do that? North Indians do like this. So why do we do it? Because again through the Agni Tattva, we're not going to directly burn our hair, right? We're just going to smear it like this. So why do we do it like this? Because through Agni Tattva and the ether, the Akasha Tattva, we're just taking it inside us. So all this has its own significance. Try to practice and see. You will know the difference very soon. Kumkum, Vibhuti, they're all very small things that you can do. But as you progress, as you evolve, as you experience, I'm sure you'll come back to me and say you want more tips on what to do next. And that time, I will definitely create another video just for you. Thank you so much, and leave your comments below this video so that I know exactly how you feel about this, and what exactly is your problem, if at all you have any, and I can address that directly. Thank you so much. I wish you all the best. Take care.